وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
Should we, as parents, say certain adhkar on behalf of our young children? For example, when they sneeze, should we say for them, Alhamdulillah? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala abdillahi wa rasulih nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So there are two situations here. The first is when a parent says these adhkar as a means of teaching their children and developing their habits. And inshallah, there is no harm in this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to teach young children the things that they needed. As we heard in the course, for example, the hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to the young boy, Ya ghulam, semmillah. O young boy, say bismillah. So there is no harm if a child sneezes and the parent is trying to teach them the habit of saying, Alhamdulillah. Say Alhamdulillah. Why just say Alhamdulillah? And the child says Alhamdulillah, for example. There is no harm. Or the parent wants to say it in order to teach the child. So this, for the purpose of teaching and developing habits, inshallah ta'ala, we hope that there is no harm in this. The second issue though is saying so without this reason, such as to a baby, for example. And in this matter, the scholars differed. However, it definitely shouldn't be done as a regular habit because there isn't any clear evidence for doing so. But if the parent says so occasionally without a specific belief that this is a sunnah, then we hope that there is no harm in this, inshallah ta'ala. So again, we're going to split it into two. Saying adhkar to your children or on behalf of your children for the purpose of teaching them, this we don't see any problem with, inshallah ta'ala. And the issue of just saying adhkar on behalf of your children in order for that dhikr to be effective for them. And in this, what we say is that we say that it should definitely not be done habitually. It shouldn't be done all the time. If a parent does it occasionally, then some of the scholars allowed this. However, others among the scholars didn't allow it at all. And we should also be clear that there are specific adhkar which you can say for your children. Like, for example, in the hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعوذ الحسن والحسين رضي الله عنهما أعيذكما بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek refuge on behalf of al-Hasan wal-Husayn رضي الله عنهما by saying, I seek refuge for you, not saying أعوذ but أعيذكما, with the perfect words of Allah, from every shaitan and every beast and every envious eye. So the Prophet ﷺ actually used to say those words to seek protection on their behalf. And this is excluded from the discussion. This is perfectly acceptable. And it's a sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ to use a dua like that. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.